Myself, Jivin, Dr. Pramila Kazla, Assistant Professor in Department of Physiology and Biochemistry in Faculty of Homeopathic Science from Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. We have already discussed about the heart structure and cardiac cycle. So now our today's topic is cardiac output. So what is cardiac output? Cardiac output is the amount of blood pumped from each ventricle. Usually, it refers to left ventricle output through aorta. Cardiac output is expressed in three ways. First one is stroke volume, then minute volume, and last one is cardiac index. So, what is stroke volume? It is the amount of blood pumped out by each ventricle during each beat. So, normal value of stroke volume is 70 ml. When the heartbeat is normal, that is 72 per minute. Now, what is minute volume? Minute volume is the amount of blood pumped out by each ventricle in 1 minute. It is the product of stroke volume and heart rate. Minute volume equals to heart rate, stroke volume multiplied by heart rate. Okay. Now, normal value of minute volume is 5 liter per ventricle per minute. It means 5 liter from each ventricle in a minute. Now I will tell you about cardiac index. It is the minute volume expressed in relation to square meter of body surface area. It is defined as the amount of blood pumped out by per ventricle per minute per square meter of body surface area. So normal value of cardiac index, that is 2.8 per square meter of body surface. Now variation in cardiac output. There is two type of variation, that is physiological variation and pathological variation. First, we will discuss about physiological variation. Cardiac output depends upon many factors like as age. In a child, cardiac index is very high, but cardiac output is low. In second one is sex. In female, cardiac output is low as compared to male. Now, body build also affect cardiac output. Diurnal variation. In diurnal variation, cardiac output is low in morning. After that, it increase. Environmental temperature. Cardiac output remains same up to 30 degrees Celsius. But after 30, cardiac output increase if temperature increased. In emotional conditions like as anger, nervousness, anxiety, cardiac output increase. After meal, cardiac output increase. After exercise, cardiac output also increase. At high altitude, cardiac output increase. Posture, in lying down condition, cardiac output is low as compared to standing position. In pregnancy, cardiac output increase because of high blood supply to fetus. In sleep, cardiac output slight become low. Increase in cardiac output. Now we will see pathological condition in which cardiac output increase and decrease. Now first we will discuss about increase in cardiac output. Cardiac output increase in following conditions. First one is fever due to increased oxidative processes. Second was anemia due to hypoxia. Third one is hyperthyroidism due to increased basal metabolic rate. After that, in following conditions, cardiac output decrease. First one is hypothyroidism due to decreased basal metabolic rate. In atrial fibrillation, because of incomplete filling of ventricles, cardiac output decrease. Third one is incomplete heart block with coronary sclerosis or myocardial degeneration. Due to defective pumping action of the heart, cardiac output decrease. In congestive cardiac failure, because of weak contraction of heart, cardiac output decrease. In shock conditions, due to poor pumping and circulation, cardiac output decrease. And hemorrhage condition, because of decreased blood volume, cardiac output decrease. Now we will discuss about factor maintaining cardiac output. Cardiac output is mainly determined by four factors. First one is venous return, then force of contraction, third one is heart rate, and last one is peripheral resistance. First, venous return. Venous return, that's it. Venous return means blood supply to aorta to heart from systemic from all over of body. Okay, it depends upon five factors. First one is respiratory pump, muscle pump, gravity, venous pressure, and sympathetic tone. Now, one by one, we will discuss first respiratory pump. Cardiac output increased during inspiration. Okay, cardiac pump is respiratory activity that helps the return of blood to heart during inspiration. It is also called abdominothoracic pump. Second one is muscle pump. Muscle pump is the muscular activity that helps in return of blood to heart. During muscular activities, the veins are compressed or squeezed. Due to presence of wall in vein during compression, the blood is moved towards the heart. Gravity, gravitational force reduces the venous return. When a person stands for a long period, gravity causes pulling of blood in legs, which is called venous pulling. Then venous pressure. Venous pressure also affects the venous return. Pressure in we can say pressure in veins is low as compared to artery, but in larger veins pressure gradually decreases. That is inferior vena cava and superior vena cava, we can see the pressure they are having only 5.5 mmHg. okay, at junction of vena cava and right atrium pressure also become very low, that is 4.6 mmHg. pressure in the right atrium is still low and it alter during cardiac action. Okay, last one is venous return is added by sympathetic or vasomotor tone, which cause constriction of venules. Venoconstriction pushes the blood towards heart. Second one, so we already discussed about the venous return. Second one is force of contraction. Now, cardiac output is directly proportional to the force of contraction, provided the other three factors remain constant. According to Frank Starling law, force of contraction of heart is directly proportional to the initial length of muscle fiber before the onset of contraction. Third one is heart rate. Cardiac output is directly proportional to heart rate, provided the other three factors remain constant. Moderate change in heart rate doesn't alter the cardiac output. If there is a marked increase in heart rate, cardiac output is increased. Now, peripheral resistance. What is peripheral resistance? It is the resistance offered to blood flow at the peripheral blood vessels. Peripheral resistance is the resistance or load against which the heart has to pump the blood. So, the cardiac output is inversely proportional to peripheral resistance. Now, we can measure cardiac output by direct and indirect method. Indirect method that is used in animals, first by using cardiometer, second by using flow meter. What is cardiac catheterization? Cardiac catheterization. What is catheter? Catheter is a thin radio opaque tube made up of elastic wire, rubber, plastic, glass or metal. Cardiac catheterization is an invasive procedure in which a catheter is inserted intravascularly into any chamber of the heart or a blood vessel. Cardiac catheterization is helpful to study the different variables of hemodynamics, both in normal and disease state. Cardiac catheterization was discovered by a German medical student, Werner Forssmann. That's all about cardiac output. Okay, thank you.